Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft and this fourth video in my mini-series editing this image. In the first video, we went through an assessment of the image and the things I wanted to change. In that video, I mentioned that the heather was a little bit too sharp for my liking and I wanted to soften that. We'll be dealing with that in this video, which concentrates on special effects, and I'll show you how I'm going to use the Orton effect to soften the heather. In the second video, we actually looked at processing our image in Capture One, which is how we ended up with the image that you can see on screen now in Photoshop. And in the third video, we then looked at how to edit that image using the Knit collection to emphasize some of the elements in the scene. And this was the image we produced. Now, if you missed the first few videos of this series, don't worry, I've put the links in the video information below. I'm going to start now by creating a frequency separation and use that to create an Orton effect. Now, if you haven't seen this done before, you can find information in a video that I've published previously, and again, I'll put the link in the video information below. Now, to do this, rather than me create it manually, I'm going to be using an extension panel for Photoshop called Wow Frequency Equalizer Pro. And again, I've reviewed that, and you'll find a link to the video in the information below. Now, in Frequency Equalizer Pro, there's this option here to create a quick frequency separation. And I'm going to do that, and it will decompose my image into two layers. And I'm going to set a pixel radius, and this effectively controls the level of blur in the image. And I want something around 30 pixels, given the size of this image. As a rough guide, work on the number of megapixels in your image, as this is a 24 megapixel camera. Somewhere between 20 and 30 produces the right level of blur. Let's close that down now, and I'll show you what the frequency equalizer has done. So we've got our image now separated onto two layers. We've got this low frequency layer and a high frequency layer. Now, the low frequency layer's got all the color information from the image. And as you can see, it's blurred, and that's what we'll use to create our Orton effect. The high frequency layer has all the detail, and if I turn off the low frequency, you can see what that does. But together, the two layers actually just create the normal image. There you can see I've turned off the separation that's been created, and if I turn it back on, there's no difference. This is how I create my Orton effect. So I'll go to the high frequency layer, and I'll reduce the opacity down to something around 80%. And as soon as I do that, we get this lovely blurring effect on the heather. Now, it may be too strong, but you can see it's softened the heather up very nicely. Unfortunately, it's softened up all the hillsides as well and the sky, and I don't really want that. I'll show you how we tackle that in a minute. On the low frequency layer, what I'm next going to do is duplicate it. So I'll use Command and J on my keyboard to create a duplicate, and I'll rename that Soft Glow. And I'm going to reduce the opacity of that layer down to something around 20% to start with. And now I change the blending mode of that layer to be soft light. And that creates this lovely glowing effect that enhances the saturation at the same time. So if I turn that off, you can see the original. Turn it on, and you can see this lovely glowing Orton effect now that we've got. Now, the thing for me is the Orton effect shouldn't really be applied globally to every element of the image. It starts to get a little bit samey after that. I really wanted it to deal with the heather in the foreground and possibly soften up some of the clouds in the sky. What I need to do now then is add a layer mask so that I can hide the effect. So I'll add my new layer mask, I'll invert it, and that hides the Orton effect from my image. Next, I'm going to use a luminosity mask to select the heather in my image. Now, I could use a saturation mask and that would work as well, but I think the luminosity mask will work best. And I'm going to use this panel that I've previously reviewed called Interactive Luminosity Masks, and it's a free panel that you can get. Again, I'll put the link to that video in the information below. and I'm going to create a luminosity mask. And in there, I'll create a zone mask. Now the areas you can see in white are the areas that are being selected by my luminosity mask. And I can move this left and right to either select brighter tones or darker tones. So I want to select something that's picking up on the heather, and it's probably slightly darker tones at this stage. And I can use these feather sliders to restrict or enlarge the range that's being selected. Now, I don't really want the effect to be seen in the shadows. I really want it to be seen more in the highlights. So I'm happy with that. And what I'm going to do now is create a selection from it. I'll hide that panel. And now I'll hide the selected edges so that I don't see them anymore. Now, over here, I'm on my mask that's attached to the entire group. And what I can do now is select a white paintbrush. So I'm using white with the paintbrush, and I've got the opacity set at about 50%. I've got a soft edge to the paintbrush, and the size is set suitable for this image. I can adjust the size using the bracket keys on my keyboard, so the left bracket will reduce it, the right bracket increases it. And now I'm going to just paint over the areas where I want to see the Orton effect. So the heather here is one of the areas where I want to see it. And again, the heather over here. Now I'll paint in the areas of the heather to start with, just to create that softening effect on the heather, because that's my priority. And the thing you've got to watch out for when you're using this technique is that because I'm using a soft blending mode here on the soft glow layer, it will actually darken and intensify the colour. So you may get a colour shift involved here. Don't worry if you find that the whole thing makes it look too saturated. We'll deal with that in a moment. So let's turn that off, turn it back on, and you can see that I've restricted my adjustment now just to the heather. If you look at the mask that I've created, you can see that it used the luminosity information that I picked up in the luminosity panel. And I just soften the edges of the path as well slightly. Now I'm reasonably happy with that. Maybe we want to include a very slight soft glow in the distance. That looks reasonably good. And now maybe just on these clouds here to soften them up. Possibly those clouds as well. So let's look. That was the original, and that's my softened image using my Orton effect. So I'll just rename that layer now. If I think that the image is looking a little bit too saturated now, what I can do is add a hue and saturation layer. I'll just make sure that that's outside of my Orton effect on the layer stack. Now, because I already had a hidden selection that I was painting through, it's actually created that adjustment as a mask. So I'm just going to remove that mask and just add a new one. In the hue and adjustment layer, we've got the master saturation, and that will allow me to control the saturation on the master layer, which I probably don't want to do too much. And it would also allow me to then pick a layer. Now in here, we've got the magentas that are in the heather, and I can pick those. And it's actually saying that we've got them as red. Now, if I wanted to, I could shift those and turn them into a different colour. So maybe I do want to shift them very slightly. And I could also increase or reduce the saturation level depending on what I felt was appropriate. And I could actually change the lightness or brightness of those. Now, if I look back at my original image with that turned off, I'm actually happy with that. So I'm not going to make any further adjustments to this. I'll remove the hue and saturation level, and I'll just accept that I'm happy with that image now. If you feel it's a bit too light or too dark, I would suggest adding a curves layer to it so that you can lighten it up or darken it down. I'm quite happy with that now. I think that looks like a good finished image. I'll just again make sure that I've got that curves adjustment on the very top of the image. And that's me complete. Now, this has been the first mini-series that I've tried where I've tried to demonstrate the end-to-end editing of an image, right through from assessment, through raw conversion, through enhancement using, in this instance, the Knit collection, and then onto special effects. Now, the first video, a lot of people were very keen on this mini-series. Now we've finished it, I'm hoping that you've enjoyed the series and thought it was worthwhile. If you did, please leave me a comment below, because I'm wondering whether or not to do a number of other of these mini-series where I demonstrate different tools, because I don't always use the tools that I've demonstrated and used in this series. If you want to see something else, another mini-series with another image and other tools, please let me know in the comments below and I'll see what I can do in the future. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.